Druta again in there, digging deep. It's Scannell. And now a final chance in over the line. Jack O'Donoghue stretching and getting the first score of the night. Just tries a little hard for Druta again. He's got back through. His teammates coming again. There's advantage here for Munster. And Casey looks to dart up into the Rugby tacklers, which he does, and the scrum half is over. Munster's second try.
Davidson there, you can see that slight shadow go there. It's a move just slightly left, raises his height.
Burgos now goes looking for it. Munster's defence, as it has been all night solid, but Burgos has a quick shuffle.
Taking a few balls, and he nudges his way forward, a bit of extra help as well.
So Bradbury is now on for Nick Haining, and straight into the defensive work.
Here's the back.
Munster. Again, look to turn the screw and get beyond the one score.
2-9, one stop.
Now Scannell has it, as it rumbles, keeps on moving forward. Casey now decides to have a go. Always through the gap. The scrum half. Munster celebrating, but they're there and they are. And that is the third score. And it's about time.
Why do the players hold on in there instead of getting back around and trying to stop that drive from Munster?
Set.
Number penalty.
Number 17.
This scrum, and it's Lockman that's penalised.
In that crouched position for a long time. Fatigue can set in, and it is a plan from the Edinburgh back.
Yeah, front. Easy.
Neither side accepting that the ball will go out of play. Here's Conway. Sidesteps one away from